Hey everyone, Kelsey here from Premiere Gal, and today I'm going to show you how to do selective color grading using the Lumetri Color panel. All right, let's jump into it. So first, let's show you how to change the colors to match two different shots that were shot on different cameras. So here I have two clips from Adobe stock. You can see the color of the water is different in both the shots. One is more of a lighter blue and the other is more of a teal blue. So what if I want to make the lighter blue more teal? First, we need to select the clip we want to change. Then go to Lumetri Color. Go down to Color Wheels and Match. And then from here, select Comparison View. This will bring up a new split screen comparison view. On the left is the reference shot. This is the shot we want to copy the color from. So move the slider here to the frame of your reference shot. And then on the right is the current frame in our timeline. And here you can move the playhead so you see the video that we want to change the color of. So now press Apply Match, and you'll see it made auto adjustments to the mid-tone shadows and highlights. Very slight adjustments, but you can see that the color blue didn't really change. And so this is where we need to use the hue saturation curves to change a color of an existing color. So go to Curves and go to Hue Saturation Curves. In here, we will use Hue versus Hue, and this will enable you to change a hue of an existing hue, or change a color of an existing color. And I think it's so funny that in color grading, they use the word hue. It's not like we go to a paint shop and we say, oh, I like this red hue. You say color, right? So just think of hue versus hue as color versus color. And here, use the eyedropper tool to select the blue in the lake. And this will create three points that represent the hue that we selected. And then we can adjust or add points. So we can expand the two outer points to expand the color range. And then we can pull up this point to change the color more into the teal range. And then you can click on the line to add another point and pull this up until we can visually see that the colors between the two shots are similar. And then click this little effects icon here to turn the effect on and off. And you can see just this little adjustment made a huge difference. Now the two clips play together in the timeline like they were meant to be together. And you can use the same type of selective color grading to change the color of any object in your video. For example, I have this guy here doing this awesome handstand and he has maroon pants on. And then use the eyedropper tool to select the color of the pants. And then you can move this point up or down to adjust the color, and you can also widen the color range by moving the two points out to encompass more color. And sometimes when you're changing the color of an object, depending on the color, it might affect the skin tones. So if you're interested in learning how to avoid changing the skin tones, I made a tutorial on that on my YouTube channel that you can go check out. And so that's all for this selective color grading tutorial. Be sure to leave a comment below if you have any questions and check out the full playlist just below. That's all. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.